Many people in our generation have missed it. They seek God for things and not for who God is. They are looking for healing, deliverance, breakthrough, and marriage. They are attracted to God for what God can do for them. But God is looking for true worshipers, those who worship Him in spirit and in truth. It is your heart first and foremost God wants, a pure heart, a clean heart. The Bible says, "Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God." Without holiness, no one can see God. What then is the measure of a true church? Is it mere numbers? Is it outward materialism? Or is it outward prosperity? A true church ought to be like a faithful wife, wholly set apart for a husband, faithful and devoted. People of God, Christ will reject a church full of blemish and spots. As you listen to the message, make a decision to make Jesus Christ the standard of your life. Live a holy life.
The prophet is called to do. He is called to bring light into the church of God. And that is my calling. Many of you who are watching with me, you may not agree with me. But that does not really matter. Your opinion is not God's opinion. What I am interested in is not only your opinion. I'm interested in God's opinion about each matter we're talking about. Whether you are bishop, you are apostle, you are watching me, whether you are a believer in the church, I don't have to agree with you. I'm God not to agree with you, but to agree with God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm God to agree with you. Amen. Not to agree with you, but to agree with God. I want you to open your Bibles because I want to address the church and address the church of God. When I'm talking about the church of God, I'm not only talking about this congregation. I'm talking about those that are watching us on the internet. I'm talking about those that are watching us wherever they are. Those that will hear this message. Those who belong to the body of Christ. I know that I have a very difficult task. But nevertheless, the task which the Lord has sent me to do, I'm going to discharge that task. Amen. When the Lord called me, He told me that the shepherds I have sent have led my people astray. Amen. That is my calling. They are greed, they preach for gain. And in their quest for gain, they have planted seed that is roasted. Now He told me, I want you to go and call my people back. Because I am sending you as a prophet unto the nation to call my people back. Now remember, as He called me as a prophet, the prophet primarily is an agent of light. Amen. A true prophet of God has seen first and foremost. He has seen, he has a rebellion among the believers. He has a wayward church. That is what the prophet is called to do. He is called to bring light into the church of God. Amen. And that is my calling. Many of you who are watching with me, you may not agree with me. But that does not really matter. Your opinion is not God's opinion. Amen. What I am interested in is not only your opinion. I'm interested in God's opinion about each matter we're talking about. Whether you are bishop, you are apostle, you are watching me, whether you are a believer in the church, I don't have to agree with you. I'm God not to agree with you, but to agree with God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm God to agree with you.
Amen.
Not to agree with you, but to agree with God.
Amen.
So as long as you find yourself outside the will of God, you'll find me a very difficult person. Because there is one thing I want to promise the church, I will not compromise.
Amen.
I will not compromise in the preaching of the gospel.
Amen.
This church will not compromise.
Amen.
In the preaching of the gospel, never. And I want you to watch now, there is going to be a move of God that will take place, that will shake the nation.
Amen.
We are going to see you out of this church.
Amen.
Yes. The time is coming where you say, I will not go to that church. It's now, but the time is coming.
Amen.
God is laying your life a foundation.
Amen.
When the foundation is complete, you will never be able to ignore the presence of God in this place.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell to your neighbor and say, do not allow yourself to be an agent
of Satan.
There are agents right now here this morning. But don't worry, the fire of God is all around the sanctuary. There's nothing. There's nothing. You fall here. You are going to fall here. Here you fall. If you are not of God, here you will touch the ground. You touch the ground.
Yes.
Very clear. Open your Bible. I'm just setting the stage. I'm not the preacher. I'm setting the stage, the atmosphere. For the preaching of the word of God. Go to the book of Ephesians, chapter 5. Ephesians, chapter 5. Verse 15, I will read from verse 15. So be careful, our belief, not as fools, but as those who are wise, make the most of every opportunity for doing good in these evil days. Don't act thoughtlessly, but try to understand what the Lord wants you to do. Don't be drunk with wine, because that will ruin your life. Instead, let the Holy Spirit fill you and control you. Then you will sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs among yourselves, making music to the Lord in your hearts, and you will always give thanks for everything to God, for the God in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let's turn to verse 27 of the same chapter. He did this to present himself as a glorious church without a spot or wrinkle or any other blemish. Instead, she will be holy and without fault. In the same way, husbands ought to love their wives as they love their own bodies. The intention of Christ is that he is coming for a holy church. He is coming for a church that has no spot, no wrinkle, no blemish, no such thing. So the measure of the true church of God is not mere numbers. The measure of the true church of God is not in mere numbers. It's not outward professional faith. The true church of God is not merely a combination of numbers. The true church of God is a holy church. That is the measure of the true church. When you go in the book of Revelation, when God was speaking to the Apostle John, he never referred to the numbers. He referred to the character, to the holiness of the church. So the numbers, don't be fooled about the numbers. Yes, God wants the church to grow. Yes, this church will grow to be a large church. But before it grows, there must be something that must happen. There must be a foundation of holiness and purity. When that foundation is alive, then the church will grow. Then the church will do what it's supposed to do.
Amen.
So we are not merely interested in what? In numbers. We are interested in holy believers. Believers who are going to heaven. That's what we are interested in. Don't worry about this church. It's not you who is going to cause it to grow. It's not me who is going to cause it to grow. It's the owner of the church, Jesus Christ. In his own time, he will cause it to do what he's supposed to do. So please, help me and give a clap over the hand of the Lord for his goodness and his mercy. So if you are in the house, You must know my heart. You must know my heart. My heart, I stand for holiness. I stand for righteousness. I stand for purity. That is what I stand for. If you are a rebellious person, a person who doesn't want to repent, I have nothing to do with you. Because God has nothing to do with you. You have received the knowledge. You have received the truth. It's time for you to turn back to God.
This is Voice of Restoration TV, television inspired to change the nation and the world. Keep watching.